One, two, three, go.
Spiritual Grandpa Chapel, this is for you. Today is the Sabbath, and he always protected the Sabbath, and he always respected it, and he always honored it. I'll read the most important Bible verse in the King James Version of the Holy Bible, St. John 3, 16 and 17. For God so loved the world. That he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. and Psalm 23. This is a psalm that I could say by heart, but I'd rather read it. It's the shepherd's psalm, and my mother's been known to tell me to read it for 30 days at a time, right before I go to sleep. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalm 23. We humans should be fighting for our love of the atonement of Christ Jesus and not for you to steal my life or my wife or my house. The villains in this here story, the Miss Eugenia justice story, they now face metaphorically the legal hounds of hell. The feds have taken the case, and the villains have no immunity because they violated the American Disability Act. And they lost their qualified immunity. They abused a 10-year-old boy at the Lake Gunnersville State Park emotionally and of a sexual, perverted nature. They also defamed the crown jewel for the Alabama state park system. They defame the image and likeness of George C. Wallace. And Lurleen Wallace, they built Lake Gunnersville State Park. They were both governors, and she was the first female governor. Our current governor, Governor Kay Ivey, is a big fan. I learned that when I toured the governor's mansion a couple of times with Brother Chapel. Her idol, her political idol, was Lurleen Wallace. And I'm sure Lurleen Wallace is very proud of Governor Kay Ivey residing in the governor's mansion and doing a fine job. At a very turbulent time, a lot at stake. finances are tight. And it just seems like a lot of things have declined. Our nation is nearly spiritually bankrupt. Intoxicants have played a big role in this. Hollywood has played a big role in glorifying gangsterism and a hedonistic lifestyle. But it's what must happen for the pendulum to swing. I ask that you pray fervently for a worldwide spiritual revival. God is the only answer, however you comprehend God. God, the term, is synonymous with good. Spiritual Grandpa Chapel always wore these golden rattlesnake boots. And he also wore this World War II veteran cap. He never left the house without them. Not once. The lion represents courage. And I had a lady tell me she wanted to hear the metaphor of the father of the five sons, as well as the lion son of the lioness mother. So I'll cover that briefly. Before I do, I want to cover the Ten Commandments. You can read them in the back of a King James Holy Bible. Number one is that thou shalt have no other gods before God. Number two is that thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image. Number three is that thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Number four is respect the Sabbath. Number five is respect your parents. The parents are not to provoke their children. Number six is thou shalt not kill. Number seven is thou shalt not commit adultery. Number eight is thou shalt not steal. Number nine, thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. Number 10 is thou shalt not covet a neighbor's life. And their property. The metaphor regarding the father and five sons is very simple. And I'll give you the short version because it ties in with what we're up against in Marshall County. The word is unfathomable, and that means it's believable but impossible to understand how people could be so cruel, so ignorant, and so satanically possessed with all the information that's out there. And the consequences well known for such barbarity, how people could be so cruel so ignorant and so satanically possessed. So the short version of the father and five sons is this. A man and wife raise five boys, and they all become professionals in their given fields. One is a sheriff's deputy, the other's a police officer, the other is an air conditioner repairman and installer, the other's a locksmith, and the other installs, monitors security systems. These five boys become wealthy in their chosen fields and as a family collectively. They acquire great wealth, and enormous contracts in gated country club communities and the like, whereby their services are highly desired because they're trustworthy. And imagine metaphorically that a scandal hits this community and it's actually an organized theft ring, a mob family, and each of the boys play their role in burglarizing businesses and fine homes. Lakefront properties, gated country club community properties, multi-million dollar businesses. And it's real easy to understand the air conditioner business owner knows how to gain access through the air conditioner ductwork and the locksmith can open any safe or door, and the security business owner, well, he knows how to bypass all security systems, regardless that you have Wi-Fi or the latest technology. He's able to manipulate any system to his advantage. And then naturally you have the sheriff's deputy and the police officer that is making sure that they're not apprehended or detected. But they're eventually caught. And what just shocks this community even more to the core is the father is the evil mastermind. And the boys have just purchased a big fine home for their father with the stolen loot. If you don't think something like that can happen, just talk to an FBI agent or a seasoned law enforcement officer, like with the state police. The metaphor regarding the son lion of the lioness, the male offspring to the female lioness, is this right here. And again, if you don't think that can happen with the five sons and the father, then you just don't understand the nature of the human criminal mind. It's happened in various forms. Google Bernie Madoff if you want to know about betrayal. But anyway, on a grand scale, this metaphor was created by watching nature videos It's true. You can watch them on YouTube. And the night camera vision is amazing. You put up these night cameras and you watch the animals at night, and in the African safari, you can see this literally happen. And again, you can search YouTube and see this for yourself. A female lioness is walking through the African safari at night, and she's surrounded by about 50 hyenas, and they want to eat her alive. And the way they do it is they wear her down, and they get in front of her, some of them, to get her attention, and she's swatting at them. And then there are those that sucker punch her from the back, and they run and grab her with their fangs, and they bite her real quick and dart to the left or the right. And they're all making this maddening sound. It sounds like they're laughing. And there are real hyenas at Tigers for Tomorrow. I suggest you spend nominal entry fee and take your family. They were rated Alabama's number one zoo in 2023. So after about 5 to 8 hours of this sabotage by these 50 hyenas against this one female mother lioness, and they've just worn her down, they want to exhaust her where they can then go in for the kill. They want to expend her life energy so they can eat her alive. Folks, this is what Marshall County, Alabama, USA, officials, mafia, gangsters have done to Miss Eugenia, my mother, in a way. They death targeted her because she would never be part of their white supremacist, radical Baptist clan of gangsters. So they audited her, then they extorted her, and then they sabotaged her. And they audited her and determined by the Alabama Department of Revenue her net worth to be $5 to $6 million, and then extorted her for $5 million. And when she appealed that, they ordered her to mediate through a federal court hearing with a retired federal judge that was a mediator. And in essence, they said, make us an offer. We'll allow you to pay a lesser amount, but you cannot overcome the 12-member jury verdict. Well, that would render Miss Eugenia discredited from ever being licensed with the FDIC as a money services business. So they came for $5 million with a lie, calling her a liar when she had done nothing wrong. They said, you're a liar, three words. No, she's not. She's never lied. She's never cursed or used profanity. I've never known her to sin, ever. I've never seen her upset. Righteous indignation, yeah, disappointment with the cruelties and the ignorance, the barbarity. But of human violence, but I've never seen her lose her cool. Not once. Cool under fire, Miss Eugenia. And she's still cool under fire. She just keeps singing, folks. She tours with Mountain Valley Singers and another choir group, and they go to churches and nursing homes. And any such event that will book a gospel traveling choir. And they do it as a labor of love. There's no money involved. They don't even request a love offering. They just want to keep singing, and they do. Music is the cure. You should be dancing. Yeah, that's the name of the tour we're working on. When Miss Eugenia's justice is manifested into reality completely, we'll put on a series of the greatest Southern rock concerts the world has ever seen. In Northeast Alabama, with the feature act, the one and only greatest Southern rock band of all time, Lynyrd Skynyrd. My brother, Damon Rogers Johnson, whom we're very proud of as the lead guitarist. It'll be a family-friendly, lighthearted music festival. No intoxicants allowed. And the ticket prices will be $5 a person, regardless of your age. Proceeds to benefit St. Jude's at 80% and 20% going to the Damon Rogers Johnson Micro Endowment for Starving Guitarists, where we'll provide guitar equipment and lessons for anyone interested in guitar, whether that be acoustic or electric. But anyway, when the male lion, the sun lion, sees his mother being brutalized by these beastly, ravenous, pestilent, despicable hyenas. They stink. They're scavengers. They eat dead carcasses. Pestilent. They spread disease. Predatory. And scavengers. They eat decomposing carcasses. Nasty, nasty, nasty. The son starts running toward his mother, and the hyenas scamper. You can see it on nature videos. It's true. Why? He'll have her back. They won't be able to sucker punch her from behind. See, when they sucker punch her from behind and grab her and bite her and dart to the left or the right, she turns and swats and roars, and they're just expending her energy so they can kill her. We bring the big gun, love, telling people they are beautiful, they belong, that they are loved regardless of their address, their age, their gender, their race, their disability, their finances, their religion, their education. We each are a child of God. They all know it. They just think they can game God and game the system. And they can, until they can't. Put the walk of shame on the sheriff, folks. He should have told Margaret of Memphis, "Don't talk like that, Margaret. I have you indicted." on bank fraud charges. Instead, he joined in on a sabotage bank fraud conspiracy to steal $1 million property and exonerate, attempt to do all this, attempt to sabotage, an attempt to force foreclosure by sabotage, an attempt to exonerate Marshall County from the scathing rebuke of the Supreme Court of Alabama under the governance of Chief Justice Tom Parker and the unanimous Supreme Court that found Marshall County judicial system guilty of felony crimes, jury tampering, $5 million extortion, and none of the judges had the love or the fortitude to stand up for their comrade in law, David Evans, and tell him, don't do that. It could backfire on the civilized world. Why would they stop him? They were in on it. But anyway, spirits for Grandpa Chapel. He said, be kind to every kind and love all animals. Spiritual Grandpa Chapel was a rare and magnificent human being whose life showed us what we have and what we can lose. He supported and defended the United States Constitution and loved all animals. Like, share, and subscribe. I'll leave you with a special song, Three Bird by Lynyrd Skynyrd. When I asked Miss Eugenia what her favorite Lynyrd Skynyrd song was, she said, Free Bird. And I said, it's not Freedom, Alabama? And she said, Free Bird. And I said, why? And she said, you can't have a sweet home if you're not free. Yeah. Marshall County, Alabama, USA, officials, mafia, gangsters, or practice at the art of deception. It's true. They are practiced at the art of deception, rank hypocrisy, and rank duplicity. Hypocrisy, rank simply means high level. Hypocrisy is not just two-faced. It's when you claim to be moral when you are immoral. You claim to be ethical when you're unethical. It's not just being two-faced or someone you're not. Search YouTube for Jimmy Swaggart prostitute interview and you'll see a real charlatan. High-powered white man taken in the 80s approximately $125 million a year through the Jimmy Swaggart Ministries, one of the top three television evangelists at the time. And you find out what he was really doing in New Orleans. Not as advertised. Gonna tell you how to live. And he's spending your money unwisely. Miss Eugenia is offering an opportunity for politically corrupt Alabama to atone for what politically corrupt Alabama has done to her and her family. Like, share, and subscribe. Pray for us. We pray for you. Thank you.